Ladies and gentlemen, there is a new snapshot out, 21w38a. If you want a look at all the gameplay changes, check out my main update video right here. In this one, we're going to go through all the technical changes, including a more detailed look at the new simulation distance and thread counts, and a bunch of changes to custom world files. My name is slicedlime, let's dive in, starting with performance. The new simulation distance setting is a slider in the video settings in the game client. You can also change it on a server, where you'll find it as a simulation-distance property in the server.properties file. This allows you to scale up your render distance without having to put more load on the CPU by simulating more entities. Note here that as of this snapshot, blocks will still tick outside the simulation range. Another new setting is for the thread count used by the game. The maximum limit is now 255 threads for the background calculations done for world generation. The actual number of threads will then be adjusted according to the number of processors in your system. This can be limited, which might be useful if you want to run multiple servers or instances on the same computer, for instance. That is done by setting a Java system property when you start the game, called max.bg.threads. A quick note here before we move on. If you appreciate these technical videos, please take a second and boop the like button. It helps the video get shown to more people, so I do appreciate it. Now, the rest of the technical changes in this version are all about custom worlds. The diff for this version in the vanilla files is fairly large, mostly because the old vanilla configuration have all been removed. All the configurations that used to be called prototype underscore something now have the prototype prefix removed, and so all of the biomes referring to them have been updated as a consequence. Trees have also been changed. The sapling underscore provider field has been removed. Instead, there are now new filter decorators that test for a condition and abort the feature placement if the condition is not met. There are two such filters added in this version. The first one is the block survives filter decorator. This tests that a certain block state would survive in the location and aborts the feature placement if it wouldn't. This is what is now used for trees to check that a sapling would survive before placing the tree. There's a new underscore checked file for each tree to look at as a reference. The configuration is simply the block state to check. There's also a new block filter decorator. This has a list of allowed blocks and a list of disallowed blocks, as well as an offset. If the block at the offset matches an allowed block, the placement is done. If it matches one of the disallowed blocks, it's aborted. If it matches none of them, then placement is allowed only if the allowed list is empty. If you want an example of this, check out the trees for the grove vegetation, which use this filter. For instance, spruce on snow. There are also a few block provider renames in this version. Noise 2D provider is now called noise provider, dual noise 2D provider is now called dual noise provider, and noise 2D cutoff provider is now called noise threshold provider. And that's it for the technical changes in this version. My thanks to you amazing people who watched all the way to the end of the video, I do appreciate it. If you want even more of my content, why don't you try out this video too?